We're on Menachot Perek Tet, Mishnah Aleph, first Mishnah, and then I chapter Masechet Menachot. We're not going to talk about the measurements. The Mishnah turns its attention to measurements in the Beit Hamikdash. Says the Mishnah, Shtei Midot Shayavesh Ayuba Mikdash. There were two measurements. There were two, like, you know, measurements or measuring cups of Yavesh for dry goods. Isaron v'chatzi Isaron. Either an Isaron. Remember, we learned in Isaron. Let's go back to the Rishimot, the list of the Midot. Okay. Isaron of the Omer was a tenth of an Ephah. And then we had an Ephah was three Se'ah. So if we go back to our chart, if we go back to our the chart that we made here, okay, Isaron was a tenth of an Ephah. Okay, Omer has Isaron Mishlosh Se'im, Shtei Alechem Shnei Esronim, Lechem Vapanim, okay, Esrim Arba Se'in, or Esrim Arba Esronim. So it was all measured in Esronim, just to remind you. Let's go back to our Mishnah. And therefore, you only need an Isaron, but also a Chatzi Isaron, a half an Isaron. Rabbi Meir says, Isaron, v'chatzi Isaron. They had two kinds of Isaron, and then a half Isaron. Okay, why two kinds of Isaron? We'll see later on, because first of all, it says in the Pasuk, Isaron, Isaron, v'keves ha'echad. So if you look at the book, it says, Isaron, Isaron. Why does it say two? It means there are two of them, okay? If there are two, then why do you need two? Ela achat mechuka v'achat gedusha. One of them was gadush. Gadush is like overflowing, okay? And machuk is like exact amount. You know, when you like measure for baking, you like flatten it off. So my question, I don't really understand, because if you wanted gadush, then why would I need a second measurement for an overflowing isaron, like a big isaron, as opposed to a small isaron? Use a regular isaron and have it overflowing. Not exactly sure, but that was Rabbi Meir's opinion. He said based on the pasuk. Gdusha Shabbat, yeah, Modin Kol Menachot. Gadush. Let me make sure I got that word right. Yeah, Gadash, heap up. He overflowing. So Gdusha is overflowing, like overflowing, heaped. Gdusha. Okay, so that, and I got that right. That's important. An important word to know. So he had two measurements. One Gdusha. So Gdusha Shabbat, Modin Kol Menachot. Overflowing measurements. Mechuka Shabbat, yeah, Modin Chabite Kohen Gadol. The Chabite, the fried. We'll see the fried korban of the Kohen Gadol. So he said they would do it. So he said you need two separate measurements based on the pasuk. Chachamim disagreed, probably because of what I said. Who knows why? Isaron ma'ayam shamesh. What would he use for the isaron? Shabu ayam odeh b'chol ha-menachot. All the menachot were isaron. Lo ayam odeh lo b'shal shloshat lapar v'lo b'shal shnei ashnayim la'ayel. They wouldn't have like a three isaron for a par. Shloshat ashnayim la'par, shnei ashnayim la'ayel. Isaron le'keves, rather, ela. Modedam, yes or no? One, two, three. Okay, chatzi isaron ma'ayam mishamesh. So why would they have a half isaron? Shabuaya moded chavite kohen gadol. Remember, the kohen gadol's korban had to be mechza baboker u'mechza ben arbaim, half in the morning and half in the afternoon. So it's very interesting. But how would they do this? Okay, how would they do half? Because in the end, it's all one big thing. Hachi garzinan. This is what we said. Isaron chatzi isaron ma'ayam mishamesh. Shabaya Modin Chabite Kohen Gadol, that's our girsa, our version. This is what it means. Chabite Kohen Gadol may be Beito Isaron Shalim. He has to bring a whole Isaron. V'chotzeyu b'chatzi Isaron Shabay Mitash. And then he divides it into two with the half Isaron measurement. V'lash kol chatzi Isaron b'fnei atzmo. And then he would need each half Isaron by itself. V'oseh mikol chatzi Isaron shesh chalot. From every half Isaron he would make six loaves. Shehen lishnei chatzai Isaron shtei mesei chalot. 12 in total. Then, it's interesting, so he would divide it, remember, half in the morning, half at night. And then he would bake them all together. Then he would take all the chalot that are baked together, mixed up now, and divide those into two, each one in half. 6 in the morning, 6 at night. And before he did that, remember, we learned he would divide them, he would break them up into kizitim. And then he would divide it in half and not into four, as we learn in the Perek Vav in chapter 6. Okay, even the rest of the menachot would be to four. Remember, he would have to divide them into like kezayit and half kezayitim. Then he would do, remember, he would do the kmitza and get the other small halves of the side. So only as this amount, and that he would put in the kli, and that he would offer on the mizbeach. We'll stop here. Dedicate our learning to the memory of my father, Rav Simcha ben Yitzchak Kalman. Make it a great day.